Yeah, good morning students. This is video 33 regarding unit 5. Okay, in this video we are going to discuss about the introduction to the 5th unit, that is the network layer. In the network layer, what we are going to discuss is, this is the syllabus for the unit 5. That is, in the network layer we are going to discuss about network designing issues of the network layer. And after that, we will discuss about the store and forward mechanisms, what we are using, and switching services. That is, I told you, whenever we are discussing about the OSI layers, I told you that each and every layer must provide some services to the above layer. That is nothing but the protocol and the interface. We discuss about the interface and protocol in the first unit. What do you mean by interface? Interface is nothing but the below layer need to provide some services to the above layer. That is nothing but an interface. What do you mean by protocol? That is, here we are going to discuss that two systems are there. That is, A is one system, A is one host, and B is another host, where the layer in one system will provide some services to the layer in another system. That is, one host will provide some services to the another host, like this. The same layer, which is, for example, here we are discussing about the network layer. The network layer in one system will provide some services to the, or provide, will have an agreement with the network layer of another system. That is nothing but the protocol. Okay, what is an interface? Interface is nothing but, which is protocol. This is nothing but protocol. Whereas here, the below layer will provide some services to the above layer. That is nothing but an interface. Okay, and that is about the designing issues. That is, the designing issues, we need to discuss about the store and forward mechanism, and after that we need to discuss about the services provided by the transport layer to the above layer. Services provided by the network layer to the above layer, that is the transport layer, and implementation of service or connection oriented services and connectionless services. We will discuss about the connection oriented service. What do you mean by connection oriented service? And after that we will discuss about the connectionless services. And after that we will discuss about the virtual circuit and a datagram network. Virtual circuit and datagram network, right? We will discuss about these two things. After that, we will discuss about the congestion control mechanisms. Congestion control and the network layer, you can main major intent, two things you have. That is, one is congestion control mechanisms, and second one is routing mechanisms. These two are very important. Whenever we are discussing about the OSI layers, we discussed about the functionalities, right? Regarding that, I told you at that time that network layer will provide two functionalities. One is the routing algorithm, and second one is the congestion control mechanism. Okay. So if you this, and after that, there are two approaches in congestion control. One is the open loop congestion control, and second one is the closed loop congestion control. If you discuss all these three, all these things, we will complete the 5th unit. This is the overview of 5th unit. Okay. Now we will go in detail. Right? How many layers are there in OSI ISO model? That is 7 layers. We already know. I told you how to remember that. Please, that is physical layer P. Please do not touch Sachin Patni Anjali, right? Patni Anjali. That is application layer, presentation layer. This is the application layer, this is the presentation layer, this is the session layer, transport layer, network layer, data link layer, and physical layer. These are the different layers of OSI model. Okay. Different layers of OSI model, right? Out of this, network layer is the 5th layer from the top. It will provide some functionalities to the transport layer, right? It will provide some functionalities to the transport layer. Now, next one. A network layer is concerned with getting the packets from the source, and it is throwing away the packets. And packets ni pumpichinamu, teesukodam, pumpichinamu, network layer yokka functionalities. To achieve the goals of the network layer, one must know about the topologies of communication of the subnet and choose appropriate path. You need to have an idea regarding this, right? Are you getting my point? You need to get an idea, that is how we are going to take the packets and how you are going to send the packets. Okay, one second. Right, how you are going to take the packets and how you are going to this, that is designing issues of the network layer. Totally the fifth unit is divided into three, you can divide it into four parts. That is, one is the routing algorithms, and after that congestion control mechanisms. We need to discuss about the congestion control mechanisms also. Okay, after that, first one is store and forward packet routing. What are the designing issues of the network layer is store and forward mechanisms. Store and forward mechanism, that is nothing but whenever a packet arrives at a particular point, whenever, for example, this is a router, in the intermediate, it is an intermediate router, and this is how the network looks like. This is a sender and this is the destination, that is A and B. Okay, what is the designing issues, and then network layer design chestunnetappudu em em responsibilities unnai dani ani cheppi telusukunnatlayite we can design that, right? We can design that. Therefore, what we need to discuss about the store and forward mechanism. Store and forward mechanism means whenever a packet arrived at a router, for example, what the packet or how the packet will be forwarded. That is, let us consider this is the router. Every router has some capacity. Every router has its own buffer. Every router has its own buffer. Why we are storing and forwarding? This is very important. Whenever a packet, the packet is arriving like this. This is the packet arriving at the router. What we will do is, I will take this packet and I will store it in its buffer. I will take this and I will store it in my buffer. Okay. I will take this and I will store it in my buffer. After storing, whenever the outgoing link is free, I will place that it in the outgoing buffer, outgoing link, right? That is, this mechanism is nothing but store and forward mechanism. Whenever we have a particular router X, this is the router X. Whenever a packet is arrived at a router X, what we are doing is we will take the packet and we will store it in our buffer. And whenever the outgoing link is free, then we will put the packet onto the outgoing link. Why we are doing this? That is very important. Why we are doing this type of mechanism? Let us consider that this is the router X. This is the intermediate router. Now, the outgoing link is like this. This is the outgoing link and these two are the incoming links. Let us consider these two are the incoming links and this is the outgoing link. In this link, we can 50 packets are arriving per second. Let us consider 50 packets are arriving on this link and 50 packets are arriving at this link. Right, per second we are getting at a router X, we are getting 100 packets per second. Okay, but what is the capacity of the outgoing link? Let us consider this is the 75 capacity. That means we can forward only 75 packets per second. Okay, 75 packets per second. That means we are getting 100 packets per second, but we can transmit only 75 packets per second. What is the thing we need to do? That is, we need to discard 25 packets out of that means out of 100 packets we can forward only 75 packets. The remaining 25 packets will be lost. Remaining 25 packets are be lost అయిపోతుంది. Okay, to overcome this, what we have done is we have set one buffer here which is capable of handling 1000 packets, or which is capable of handling 1000 packets. It can store 1000 packets at a time. What we are doing here is, whenever these 100 packets arrive, I will place this 100 packets in this buffer. What we will do, 100 packets for the first second, 100 packets will come and sit here, right? For the first second, 100 packets will come and sit here. Now, for in the first second, what we are doing, we are placing out of these 100 packets, we are placing 75 packets on the outgoing. Therefore, only 25 packets will be there in the buffer. Now, in the second second, again 100 packets is there. 100 plus 125, previous 25 is there, 125 packets will be there. And in the second second, we are again forward 75 packets onto the outgoing link. Therefore, what is the remaining? Therefore, we have 50 packets. Like this, we are going to take the packets and store it in the buffer so that we will never discard the packets. Discard cheyalsi necessity rather mara. Okay, na? Are you getting my point? Like this, we can maintain the buffer. We can maintain the data inflow by without neglecting or without discarding for minimum some time. That means ee flow ganaka itlage oka 10 minutes continue aina maximum entante buffer nindochu gaani oka 10 minutes varaku nenu sustain avagalugutha ee 10 minutes lopala incoming gaani outgoing incoming yokka capacity tagachu ante the incoming packets will decrease may decrease to 10 this incoming packets may decrease to 10 at that time what we will do is 10 plus 10 20 and remaining whatever left in the buffer I will place 75 packets on this outgoing then we will try to empty the buffer ante entante incoming flow ganaka ekkuva unnappudu nenu em chestanante ekkuvaina buffer ekkuvaina data edaithe undo danni buffer lo place chestanu eppudaithe outgoing incoming flow tagutundo appudu nenu em chestanante buffer lo teesi forward chestu untanu so that the buffer will be empty that is the main advantage of store and forward mechanism ganaka lekapothe em avutundi ante store and forward mechanism ganaka lekapothe we need to discard some packets out of 100 packets we need to discard 25 packets every time that means these 25 packets need to be retransmitted by the host ane vaadu malli retransmit cheyali appudu malli problem vastundi andukani em chestam ante retransmission jarigind anko again 50 plus 25 what happens 50 plus 25 means again it will go and it will be create a problem therefore what we are going to do is we are going to take a buffer and we will place that packets into the buffer after the outgoing channel is free I will place that packets onto the buffer this is how we are going to maintain that is store and forward switching mechanism will be implemented and we need to provide the second one is we need to provide we will not discuss what are the services we are providing it is an abstract model at the first unit only I told you that this is an abstract model we are not going to discuss what are the services we are providing but we will tell you that some services are going to be provided it is an abstract model we will not specify abstract model and TNT we will not specify the details but we will specify what are the services okay services provided to the ట్రాన్స్పోర్ట్ లేయర్ కి సమ్ సర్వీసెస్ ప్రొవైడ్ చేయాలి అని చెప్తాం నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఈజ్ ఇంప్లిమెంటేషన్ ఆఫ్ కనెక్షన్ లెస్ సర్వీసెస్ అండ్ ఇంప్లిమెంటేషన్ ఆఫ్ కనెక్షన్ ఓరియంటెడ్ సర్వీసెస్ వాట్ డూ మీన్ బై కనెక్షన్ లెస్ సర్వీసెస్ అండ్ వాట్ డూ మీన్ బై కనెక్షన్ ఓరియంటెడ్ సర్వీసెస్ ఓకే ఆర్ యూ గెటింగ్ మై పాయింట్ రైట్ Do you have any doubt? If you have any doubt, please post it in the comments so that I can go and have a clear cut what you are asking. Okay. No. Implementation of connection oriented services and implementation of connection less services. What do you mean by this? Connection oriented ante connection less ante connection oriented ante we are maintaining some reservation. That means. If you have a network like this, I want to transfer the data from host 1 to host 2. If you want to transfer the data from host 1 to host 2, in connection oriented services, what are the things happening? And in connectionless services, what are the things happening? That means I told you that at each and every router, there will be some buffers will be there, right? There will be some buffers at each and every router like this. Right. Observe carefully. What is the differences between connection-oriented services and connectionless services? Okay. This is how the buffers will look like. everything will come and sit in. That means every packet which is coming inside to the router A will first go and sit in the this buffer only, right? Now, what do you mean by connection oriented services? Connection oriented services and whatever the packets we are coming or we are taking will come and store here. For example, let us consider this is router C. Router C has the capacity of, let us consider these two are incoming links. These two are incoming links for the router. For example, A is sending 50 packets and B is sending 50 packets. Okay. That means at the router C per second, we can get around 100 packets. Now, what is the capacity of the router is, but it is not happening. Just I'm giving you a small digit, but it is not 50 packets. It may vary. It may be in thousands packets. Okay. For your understanding, I have decreased the number. That is C will get a packets from A and D at a speed of 50 packets per second. Okay. Let us consider the capacity of this router is it can store only 70 packets. What we can do right now? At this point, we need to think that at a per second we are getting around 100 packets at the router C, but we have a capacity of only 70 packets right now. What we can do? We can out of 100 packets we can store only 70 packets, and remaining 30 packets need to be discarded. Okay, remaining 30 packets need to be discarded. At this particular point of time, if D is sending a packet, that is very important. D is sending the data, that means this 50 packets are contains a sensitive information. That means it is very emergency to send the packets to host 2. For example, let us consider this is very sensitive information and this needs to be transmitted immediately. Now what we will do? That means you, even though I don't bother about the ace data on the important guys, we can retransmit the data at that time. What we need to do is I need to take these 50 packets mandatorily. That means these 50 packets need to be stored in the buffer, and remaining 20 packets we can store it from the router A. That means we can take 20 packets from the router A and 50 total 50 packets from router B. This is my requirement. What I can do at this particular point is we can make a reservation for D. That means at router C, we have a buffer, right? At router C, we have a buffer. And here, what we are doing is reserving some space for D only, not for A. That means these 50 packets need to be stored, or these 50 packets need to be occupied by the router, whatever the D is forwarding, and the remaining 20 packets I don't bother about that, but for this 50 packets need to be occupied by the packets which is forwarded by the router D only. Okay, this is my requirement. For this, what we will do is we will make some reservation by creating a connection oriented services between the router D and router C. Router D ki router C ki majlo connection oriented services ni chesam. General ga connection oriented services will be implemented at a host to host. That is host 1 nunchi host 2 ki, host 1 nunchi host 2 ki majlo data transmission appudu maatrame ee vartham ani. Okay na between host to host only we will use this type of implementation. What I am doing here is I will implement host 1. If I want to have a connection oriented services between host 1 to host 2, let us consider the connection between host 1 to host 2 is like this. Host 1 to A, A to C, and C to E, C to E, E to F, and F to H2. Let us consider this is the connection-oriented services. Let us consider this is the connection-oriented service. Whenever we have a connection-oriented service between a host to host, what we will do is at each and every router, let us consider this is the router. This is the stack or a buffer at the router C. This is the buffer at router C, E. This is the buffer at router F. What I am doing here is I will make some reservation for this type of connection. Let us call this connection as connection 1. Okay, this space is reserved for connection one. This space is reserved for connection one. This space is used for connection one. This space will be used. That means if you are implementing a connection oriented service, what we are doing is we are making some reservation at each and every router. This is nothing but the connection oriented service. కనెక్షన్ ఓరియంటెడ్ సర్వీస్ అంటే ఒక వైర్ ఉంది, వైర్డ్ కనెక్షన్ని నువ్వు కనెక్షన్ ఓరియంటెడ్ సర్వీస్ అనకూడదు. కనెక్షన్ ఓరియంటెడ్ సర్వీసెస్ రిఫర్స్ టు వీఆర్ మేకింగ్ సన్ రిజర్వేషన్ అట్ ఈచ్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీ బఫర్ ఆన్ ద రౌటర్. ఆ పాత్ మీద వెళ్ళే రౌటర్స్ ఏవైతే ఉన్నాయో ఆ రౌటర్స్ దగ్గర వాట్ వీఆర్ డూయింగ్ ఈజ్ వీఆర్ మేకింగ్ సమ్ రిజర్వేషన్ అట్ ఈచ్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీ పాయింట్. దట్ మీన్స్ దిస్ స్పేస్ విల్ బీ యూజ్డ్ బై ది డేటా విచ్ ఈస్ ఫార్వర్డెడ్ ఫ్రమ్ హోస్ట్ 1 టు హోస్ట్ 2. హోస్ట్ వన్ నుంచి హోస్ట్ టూకి వెళ్ళే డేటా అంతా కూడా ఈ స్పేసెస్ని యూజ్ చేసుకుంటుంది. అంటే ఈ స్పేస్ని వేరేవి ఏది కూడా యూజ్ చేయకూడదు. దట్ మీన్స్ ఇఫ్ యూ ఆర్ యూజింగ్ ఏ కనెక్షన్ ఓరియంటెడ్ సర్వీస్, వాట్ యూ నీడ్ టు డూ ఇస్ ఫస్ట్ యూ నీడ్ టు ఎస్టాబ్లిష్ ఏ కనెక్షన్. ఫస్ట్ యూ నీడ్ టు ఎస్టాబ్లిష్ ఏ కనెక్షన్. ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ వీ నీడ్ టు ఫార్వర్డ్ ద డేటా. ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ వీ నీడ్ టు ఫార్వర్డ్ ద డేటా. ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ వీ నీడ్ టు క్లోజ్ ద కనెక్షన్. ఎస్టాబ్లిష్ ఏ కనెక్షన్, forward the data and close the connection. These are the three steps we need to implement. That is, before a connection we need to implement the connection, the steps involved in the connection. That is establishing a connection, forwarding the data, and after that we need to close the connection. These are the three steps involved in the connection oriented services. Whereas here one important one is the reliability is there in the store, in the connection oriented service. Yes, definitely, because there is no chance of discarding the packet. Packet ni discard chese concept ledu. Enduku ante meeku discarding eppudu jarugutundi, space lekapothe buffer digger space lekapothe jarugutundi discarding. Kaani nenu eppudu nenu munne em chestunanu, prathi router digger reservation, naaku inta space kavali ani nenu reserve chesukoni pettukunanu kabatti, whenever a packet arrived at a particular router it will be stored in that particular space, right? Therefore what happened, there is no discarding of packet. Therefore reliability is more in connection oriented services. Okay, that is the advantage of connection oriented service. Next concept is connectionless service. What do you mean by connectionless service is, for example, let us consider second type of connection, that is host one is there. This is this is second type of connection. Host one is there, host one to B, and from B we have a connection to D, and from D we have a connection to E. Like this we have connection from host 1 to host 2. Okay, I am calling this as second connection. Okay, and let us consider this is a connectionless services. What do you mean by connectionless services? The difference between the connection oriented services and like connectionless services is, the only thing we need to observe here is we are not making any prior reservation. Prior reservation ledu. That means whenever a packet is arrived at a router, we will go and sit in, if there is a space we will provide the space, otherwise we will discard the packet automatically if there is no space available space. For example, A is transmitting the data at 50 packets per second, but the capacity at B is it can store only 25 packets. There is no space, extra space available to store all the 50 packets. Therefore 20 packets will be stored and remaining 25 packets will be stored and 25 packets will be discarded. That is the going to be happen because there is no space, right? Therefore 25 packets will be discarded, and for due to discarding we need to again retransmit those 25 packets. Out of 25 packet, out of 50 packets only 25 packets is going to be forward, and remaining 25 packets we need to retransmit the same data. Okay, that is going to be happen. This is nothing but connectionless. That means if you are not going to make any reservation, prior reservation, therefore all these three steps is not required in connectionless service. Connectionless services lo three steps also led em cheyali, only forward mechanism okkati unde chalu, right? Forwarding of the data is sufficient in connectionless services. That is the difference between connection oriented services and connectionless services. In connection oriented service we call it as a virtual circuit. The circuit of the reservation what we are creating is nothing but the virtual circuit, and the data packet which we are transmitting in the connectionless service is nothing but the datagram packets. Okay, this is the difference between connection oriented services and connectionless services. Here we need to discuss about the comparison between virtual circuit and datagram circuit. Okay, connection service unit ki madhyalo differences chudali. Okay na, thank you.